He is a 15-year-old student with no special habit of medical importance, presented to our unit by force attack of hematemesis. 1 month ago, he experienced the first attack of hematemesis of coffee ground blood of small amount, less than 1 cup, associated with melena, for which he received IV proton pump and fluids and sent home without upper endoscopy. 1 week later, he developed the second attack of hematemesis of fresh blood, large amount. He was hemodynamically unstable, resuscitated with fluids, bagged RBCs, full dose of proton pump infusion till becoming stable. Then upper endoscopy was done that revealed diffuse gastritis and superficial bulbar ulcer, first class 3. Few days later, the third attack of hematemesis occurred and the patient didn't seek medical advice and continued oral proton pump infusion, proton pump inhibitor only. He presented to us by the fourth attack of hematemesis of 2 cups of dark altered blood associated with melena. There is no history of any other orificial bleeding, no barbaric eruption or ecchymotic patches. He has no history of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or anticoagulant. The attacks are not preceded by vomiting, no abdominal pain or weight loss, no fever or appearance of any body swellings, no jaundice, lower limb edema or abdominal distension, no history of contact canal of water, no history suggestive of other system affection. He has no history of previous operation, previous blood transfusion except during the hematemesis or any chronic medical disease. His father died 8 years ago, suffering from pulmonary tuberculosis. His mother and other siblings are living in apparently good health. On examination at time of presentation, he had resting tachycardia and postural hypotension that was corrected after resuscitation. He was underbuilt. His body mass index was 15.6 kilogram per meter square. He was pale. He has signs of delayed puberty. His pubic hair tunnel stage 2, external genitalia tunnel stage 1. Otherwise, the examination was free. His hemogram revealed anemia, normocytic hypochromic. Otherwise, the rest of CBC was normal. His chemistry, his INR and the liver enzymes and liver function was normal apart from hypoalbuminemia. His serum albumin was 3.1. His urea was mildly elevated, matching with GI bleeding is 52. His calcium was 8.3, but corrected it was 9.2. We did EC ratio for him that was normal and the virology was negative. I will show later why we did all this virology. He did upper endoscopy that revealed normal esophagus. The stomach was full of blood clots. Washing and removal of the clots revealed multiple scattered small ulcer at the antrum and the body of about 3 to 5 millimeter with clean bases, multiple mucosal hemorrhages. The duodenum show a small healing ulcer at junction between the bulb and second part, with clean base and multiple lymphangiectasia. The lymphangiectasia. Pelvic abdominal ultrasound was done, then CT abdomen and pelvis with contrast revealed splenomegaly. It was 13 centimeter with a small splenic infarct, multiple pathological intra-abdominal lymphadenopathy, para-aortic, aortocaval, mesenteric, portocaval. The largest one was 3.5 multiplied by 3.8 centimeter. He had normal echocardiography, normal high-resolution CT chest, negative tuberculin skin test, ACE level was normal, hormonal profile was normal, beta 2 microglobulin normal, hemoglobin electrophoresis was normal. We did enteroscopy transorally down to 200 centimeter from the pyloric link, revealed only small healing gastric ulcer and the duodenal bulb and post bulbar ulcer, multiple small nodules of lymphangiectasia, scattered in the duodenum and jejunum, with multiple biopsies were taken from duodenum and jejunum. The duodenal biopsy revealed chronic duodenitis with preserved villus pattern. The biopsy from the jejunum, moderate chronic jejunitis with preserved villus pattern, free of specific infection, atabia, or malignancy. EUS was done, revealed multiple variable-sized abdominal lymph node. The largest is located at the porta hepatis. It was globular with loss of hyperechoic hilum, and the fine needle aspiration was done. This is the lymph node, and this is the fine needle. The lymph node biopsy showed non-caseating granulomatous reaction. The GI bleeding stopped and the hemoglobin level rised to 10 grams, and the patient will do follow-up sonography for monitoring the size of lymph node to decide what is next. This boy didn't stay in the hospital. He just do one of the investigation. He just stabilized the case and go home and come back for follow-up. So all of this was done over the last 2 weeks without admission except for 2 or 3 days for the patient. Now we are waiting the next decision for us. Does this case matches with sarcoidosis and we need to receive a steroid, or we need to take excisional biopsy from the lymph node? The fine needle is not conclusive, or it may be early tuberculosis and he need anti-tuberculous drugs. I just need to take your advice and your suggestion for this case.
خلصت. طب تسقيفه جامده يا جماعه بعد عشان ده الوحيد اللي التزم.